Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, the laws of a geisis, of someone that is, the death is imminent, and guarding the deceased after he passes away. And that's what we're holding right now in the halachas. And as I mentioned the other day, these are the heebie-jeebie halachas that we have in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. Not everyone likes to learn them. However, death is something that is a part of life, and everybody will go through it, and we'll be around people that this happens to. And therefore, since it's in the Kitzur, we'll continue learning it. Li'acha yitzias neshama. After the neshama, the soul has departed. Manichin etzel choyt mo'y noitza kala. We're supposed to put a feather near the nose of the person who has died. V'im eina misnad nedes. And if it doesn't move, be yidua shemes, then you know for sure that he's dead. The custom is to open the windows in the house, and the mourners, whoever is considered to be the relatives of this person that have to mourn, they say a special prayer called Tzidak Adin, which is the acceptance of Hashem's judgment. Now the custom is not to do it at that time, but rather to do it, these days we do it by the funeral itself. When they reach the words in Tzidak Adin, a blessed are you, Hashem, dying emes, the judge, the true judge, ayimim b'shem u'malchus, is supposed to say it with Hashem's name, say a bracha, v'korin kedin, and then they do the tearing, the rending of the garments, yizbar b'simin shalachazeh, that we're going to explain in the next chapter. So nowadays this is done again, as we said, at the graveside, or at some point in the funeral. And the tearing normally takes place also at the funeral as well. Anyone who is standing by the person who passes away, and they're there at the time that the soul departs from his body, the halacha is really they have an obligation to tear kriya, to rois kriya, as they say, to tear their garments. That's the tsar, the pain of watching this take place. However, nowadays, it doesn't seem to be the custom. Nowadays, anyone that's there at the time of the Yitzias Neshama, when the Neshama departs, they do not tear Kriya until really the relatives who are there by the graveside or at the funeral. What can this be compared to? The Sefer Torah Shenisraf, it's like a Sefer Torah that got burnt. That what? If someone who sees a Sefer Torah burning, they have to rend their garments. There's no person amongst Klal Yisrael who doesn't possess some kind of Torah and mitzvahs. Even on a child who learned at least a pasuk in the Chumash. A woman also learns, she learns words of Torah, and therefore you're also going to be obligated to hear Kriya. And you'll be obligated to hear Kriya over here. Even if you will find that this person sometimes did averas, he transgressed out of desire, you're still obligated to rend your garments. However, if this person sinned regularly, even if it was only out of desire, he couldn't control his desires. This is like a person who separates themselves from the ways of the community. And the halach is, you do not tear on such a person. And what was done with Kriya Zul Shi'ala Mace, She'ein Mis'ablin Love, when a person is tearing Kriya for someone that they're not obligated to mourn for. For example, it's not a mother, a father, a brother, a sister, or a child. Rather, they were there at somebody else's bedside when their neshama left them. Sagi b'kriya mu'etes, a little rip is enough. Sagi, even from the side of the garment, or the hem of the garment, even that is going to be enough to fulfill the obligation over here of tearing. Okay, we'll stop the halacha over here today, and we shall continue Be'ezat Hashem tomorrow. All the best. Have a very happy and a lively day.